Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Accident. Once again, you wanted to see another video of this, and we are going to investigate more accidents. We're going to skip the one that we did last time, which was the Swedish countryside. That was in part of the demo. Instead, we're going to play Cliffside Accident, which is in France. And then we're going to do the street race. So those are the two we're going to check out today. Let's go ahead and get it done. All right, just cruising, you know, in the Alps, no big deal. August 12th, 2014, back in the day. And it's a gorgeous day. Man, look at that. It's like photorealistic out there. The skybox looks nice. We're coming around the corner. And here is the death and destruction that we have grown to love. It is right here. And it looks like we've got some charred bodies upside down, possibly. This looks bad. This looks really bad. Okay, let's get our phone. Where's the phone? Call the emergency. There it is. Right. Hazard lights are on. Why is it locked? Where's our phone at? Oh, it's over here. Why would you put it there today, dude? Come on. Time is a-wasting. Call emergency services. Get it going. Hazard lights are already on. I didn't know you could do that before you get the phone. That's actually really cool. All right. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Emergency team's on its way. Okay, let's get going. Put out the fire. Secure the car on the edge. Turn off the ignition of the vehicles. Okay. Let's get to this one first. Dude. What? Can't do anything? Secure the car. Secure the car. Stock stone. Pick it up. Put it down. What are you doing? What is this supposed to do, huh? They're dead. All right, Groundhog's Day. Let's try to do something with this car. I think we have to do something with this car. Pick up a stone. Do something with it. Put it behind a tire. Do something. Do something. You can't do anything, can you? Can we put it back here? Oh, you have to put the stone in the back of the car. That's what it is. Good. That should be enough for a while. Take care of that fire. All right. We have a nice Porsche today. Wow. That's actually really nice. Okay. Get this. When it's easier to fire, stay safe distance. Okay. I think rather than the flames, in real life, it says at the top. In real life, by the way. Hey, we got the fire out. What a miracle. All right. Turn the ignition off all the vehicles. You got it, Joe. Can we get into this? We can't. We can't get over there, so that's impossible. All right. You guys, are you okay? I don't think they're upside down. They've been upside down for a while. They're like, take care of this. Oh, that guy looks like he might be toast. Mark incident location. Okay, let's do it. Warning triangles out. Woo! Man, this is a tough one. I will give it to them on this one. It is a tough one. Mainly, I had a lot of problems with that fire extinguisher. All right, triangle down right there. Now they're probably gonna have checked all victims, check your exact location. They're gonna be like, don't use GPS, it's inaccurate. It's like, okay, yeah, sure. We'll check them in a second. Let's check our exact location. Let's get that over. Because, you know, you wouldn't do that when you first got here anyway and you were on the phone with them, right? That would make way too much sense, man. Check sat nav. When given your location, try to avoid GPS coordinates as they can be imprecise. Use road names and distances instead. LOL. Get out. Let's go check on the people. Let's save some lives here. Ma'am, are you okay? Ariana, are you okay? Can you hear me? Nope. Open the airway. Wonderful. I wanted to remove the seatbelt, but okay. I guess that's okay. Check the breathing. Okay, she's good. She is alive. All right, good. That's one. Can't get to you, can we? We can inspect him. Oh, magically we can do this. The victim is conscious. Okay, can you hear me? No, can we do that again? He's petrified. Leave him be for now. Okay. What about you? Are you okay? I'm gonna sense that that's not the case. Okay, we've got some damage. Got a lot of damage. Ma'am, can you hear me? Nothing? Oh, we got a wound here. Okay, and then we gotta open the airway and... Gone, girl. Just toast. Okay, that's not good. All right, one of two injuries is a laceration, a bruise up there. That's what it was. Okay, what about you, dude? Are you okay? You okay? Can you hear me? Sir? Nothing? Broken neck. Toast. Dude, they're both dead. There's no way. Yeah, they're both dead. Broken neck. All right, that's that. Help the victims. Okay, I've got my first aid kit. Let's start doing some work. Try to help the man get out of his car. It may still fall at any moment. Okay, sir, can we get you out? Help get out. That was an insanely long period there. We can't help any of these people. Cannot remove them. It's too dire, it looks like. All right, what about you? Nope. All right, so we have to get in our car and wait for help to arrive so we can continue on. All right, we've got a helicopter coming in hot. Damn. Okay, that is awesome. That's actually really, really, really cool. Wow, wow, wow. Nice. Okay, they had to be airlifted out of here, it looks like. All right, new objectives. Discover the cause. Gather all the clues and put the events in the correct order. All right, so everybody's been removed. Now we have to find out how this whole nightmare happened. We've got some clues here. Got a hole in the tire, insufficient clue. Irrelevant oil puddle. What about this? Nothing there. Nothing there. Time to be a nice inspector here today. Nothing there. All right, let's start looking around. What might have caused that? Well, there it is right there. We've got skid marks. Hugo brakes too hard and understeers onto the cliff's edge. Yeah, well, we knew that happened. 100%. Impact points, a clue right here. Berenice crashes into Guillaume's car. Okay, that's cool. And go up. What does that mean, go up? Go up in elevation? Oh, we went up higher. What the hell? Okay, so there's clues up here, it looks like. Possibly. We gotta find out what... Oh, we got more tracks up here. What the hell happened here? Skid marks clue. Guillaume loses control of the car. Okay. Oh, we got something here. Scratch marks. Yellow sedan drives over a large rock and blows a tire. Okay, so that happened. And then they swerved off down there. Really? To the accident scene down there? Wow. Oh, man. Okay. What? I am absolutely just... I have no clue. No words for it. I don't know what happened. It looks like they hit something there, lost control, went off a cliff, a yellow car. I never saw a yellow car, unless they're talking about the one that's on the cliff, which I don't think that is the case, so... hard to say. Got a boulder here, it looks like. Stone is irrelevant. Okay, I think it might be something to do with this over here on the right. This hill here. Because they came down that hill. Yep, here we are. Go up. Oh, that's another way to go up. Oh, what's this? We got debris here. Showing... We got parts of a car here. What in the hell is going on? Still haven't found that last clue yet, but I'm putting the whole thing together and it makes more sense because those are parts of that car. So they lost control up there, came down the entire thing, ended up here. This person ended up getting in an accident and he avoided it by, you know, understeering off the cliff almost. So that's what happened for the most part. I'm just trying to find out. I thought there'd be more to this story, but I don't think so. I mean, we have to go back up there because we missed something on that hill. What is this? Debris, car debris. That was part of that. Sedan falls from the cliff onto the street below. That's what we thought it was. I just didn't see that. It was really, really well, you know, hidden there. Okay, let's put it together. All right, so yellow sedan drives over a large rock. Yes, that happened. Okay, and then they lose control of the car, and then they fell down the cliff to the street below. They smashed into it. It's either they smashed into it then or he lost control. I'm going to say they smashed into it and then he lost control. That's what I think happened. Finish the scenario and success. We figured it out. Ariane, when emergency services were finally able to remove her from the car, it was already too late. She died either when the car fell down the hill or when Berenice's car crashed into them. A few days after the accident, she was buried by her family. Dead. Okay. Not much of a success story there. Guillaume, I don't know how you say his name. While his car was rolling down the hillside, he hit his roof so hard he broke his neck and died. I knew they died. And I knew she was dead too. She lived. She was not seriously injured during the accident. She was revived shortly after at the hospital and lifted 2 days later. After that, she contacted Dubose and Kaplan families and helped them deal with their grief. They remain close friends to this day. Well, she lived. I thought she was gone, girl, for sure. And Hugo recovered from the psychological shock. Yeah, he almost went off the edge of the cliff. The incidents triggered severe acrophobia, fear of heights, that haunted him for the rest of his life. Fortunately, with the help of local psychologists, he was able to avoid more dangerous consequences. Okay, cool. All right, that was an interesting one. It was a little tougher than I thought it would be. This is Tennessee, USA, street race. July 27th, 2004. Back when people used to watch all those street racing videos and they wanted to be part of the problem. Tennessee, USA, July 27th, 2004. It's playing music right now and we're going to go ahead and remove those. Okay, I heard a crash during that sound, so we're on foot on this one, it looks like. And okay, we heard a crash. We see a crash up here. Something's going on. I love how this says burger, and that says automobile and steakhouse and restaurant. I mean, it doesn't get any more easier than that. Call the emergency, okay? We got a person down in the street. Oh, it's like a homeless man got hit. Cans are everywhere. Our phone is dead. Are you kidding me? Call emergency services. Anybody else have a cell phone? Oh, there's a telephone booth here. I mean, it is 2004. It's possible we can use this. Anybody there? Hello? It's horrible out here. We got cans everywhere. Anybody there? My God, it's taking forever. Thank you. I'm sending help right now. Please secure the area before doing anything else. Don't hang up and return to me if you don't know what to do. Okay, so just keep that up there. And, or pizza. Pizza! Okay, turn off the ignition in all the vehicles. Okay. That looks smashed in on that side. Let's see. Can we get in here and turn off your ignition? Sir, you okay? Oh, that looks bad, dude. That looks bad. Okay, ignition's off there. I know. Turning off the ignition in cars helps prevent an electrical system from starting a fire. Even though people have said already that you shouldn't do that in real life because you won't get the car started again if you have to, you know, roll windows down and stuff. Okay, mark accident locations next. All right. Let's put some warning triangles out. Nothing there. You don't have any warning triangles. What about you? Locked. Is there a way to... You have a trunk release in here in your glove compartment or something, bro? Trunk lock button. Okay. That'll work. Anybody else? I mean, we don't have any... Okay, there's a emergency flares, first aid kit. No warrant... Oh, flares. I was about to say, we would not have that be a thing. Okay, here's a flare here. Here in the U.S., we wouldn't have warning triangles, so we would have flares. Okay, so they had a flare. Do you guys have anything back there? No. There's a car over here. Does it? Can we break into the car? That's a nice looking car, dude. That's like an old Hurst. Can't get into it. Okay. Mark accident location 1 of 3. Do we have more flares? Where are we supposed to get more flares from? Unless they have more. Oh, and more. I see. Okay. It's making more sense now. Put a flare down here. All right. We have to go back to it and get another flare. We'll put one over here. We encourage more. All right. Flares are done. New objectives. Assess the situation. Assess the situation. Check all the victims. All right, Jason. Hey, I can see your name. Jason, can you hear me? Nothing? All right. That's not good. Undo the seatbelt and open the airway. There we go. Are you breathing? You are alive. Okay, Jason, just sit tight, okay? The airbag just went off. You hit a homeless person or something happened or you hit a car because that person was like they did a drift, a sweet drift into a homeless dude. What about you? What do we got going on here, Bethany? Bethany, can you hear me? Let's undo the... Oh, we can't undo that first. We have to... Can you hear me? Ma'am. Let's call her ma'am. Unbuckle the seatbelt and then open the airway. All right? Please be breathing. Okay, they're both breathing. They're okay. She had her skirt on. They were going out tonight, and it came to an end. Okay, what about you? What about you, dude? You've got a big, huge laceration on the right side of your face. That does not look good. Can we... Okay, Freddie Weaver. Can you hear me, Freddie? Freddie. Nothing? Okay, unbuckle the seatbelt, open the airway. Yeah, that's a nasty cut there, buddy. We got a wound, a bruise. Not breathing. We might have to do CPR on this dude. They haven't had us do CPR in a while. All right, 3 of 4. Check your exact location. Oh, yeah, because this guy's down on the ground. William Maddox. Mr. Maddox, please tell me. Okay. They had it. Okay. Check the breathing. A wound here. If you don't know, Mr. Maddox was one of Will Ferrell's... He's breathing. Okay. Will Ferrell's characters in Saturday Night Live. Generally, victims who are breathing have priority of those who are bleeding. Yep. Check your exact location. Okay. So we have to use somebody's GPS, possibly. We can't with the ignition turned off. What are we supposed to do? Oh, he doesn't even have one. Okay. I don't know. 0 of 2 of that. Exact location. Maybe we have to tell them on the phone, perhaps? I think so. I think that's what they want us to do. Tell me which intersection this is exactly. Look for street signs. Oh, gotcha. That's what they want. Street signs. Because, you know, GPS not a thing. All right. So we're the 8th. And something else. South Street. Okay. That's it? That's it? All right, we'll go tell them about it. Okay, here you go. Get an ambulance here. This is the slowest response time I've ever seen in my life. Thank you. From what you're telling me, the sports car driver is in the most dire situation. If you can, pull him out and perform CPR. Okay. They're going to have to do CPR on this dude. All right, dude. I'm going to save your life. Get back. Don't worry. I'm a professional. I'm just kidding. All right, let's get you out of here. If we can. If we can. We can't do anything. Can we pull him out this way? It's jammed. They won't let us. Oh, we have to pull him out from the outside of the car. That makes sense, right? Okay. We got him out. He's on the ground. Okay, we're going to start... need first aid kit. It's back here. Well, at least they had that on them. All right, Freddy, just sit tight, man. I'm gonna get you in good health here. Gloves are on. Open the airway. Airway is open. CPR mask time. That goes there. And then CPR 0 of 2. Here we go. Over this way. Chest compressions. Here we go. The mini game that we all love and know. Boom, boom, 2. Perfect, 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 perfect. Yeah. Get him going. Come on, buddy. That's a lot of chest compressions. Stand left. New high score. Gotta love the high score on the expense of somebody else. Failed. All right, we know what we have to do now. We have to pull him out through the roof of the car, which really wasted a lot of our time, to be honest. So we'll do that this time. Let's go ahead and get the first aid kit out. Get to him. Over here. Open it up. No messing around. Gloves on, baby. Gloves on. CPR mask. Oh, wait. We have to open the airway. There we go. And then CPR mask him. And then put that there. And then start it. Here we go. All right, dude. We're going for that new high score. Come on. We're going for the high score. We're not doing as good as we did last time, though, on this one. High score, 40,840. Okay. Artificial ventilation count. Here we go. And one and two and all right, check for breathing. Come on, check for breathing. He's not breathing. Continue CPR till help arrives. All right, so we're in Tennessee and we've got a very European siren on a high low there with, but I mean, they got the ambulance right. It's like an international style ambulance. There it is. Discover the cause, gather all the clues. All right, so this ought to be an interesting one for sure. I got bottles and cans. Clap your hands. Here it is right here. Shopping cart is a clue. William Maddox is hit by Freddy's sports car. Yeah, we knew that was happening, but I think he was trying to pull off a sweet drift around the corner, it looks like. Where did that happen? Let's gather this one up here. Impact point, of course. The Hamptons car smashes into the sports car. All right. Skid marks, do those matter? Doesn't seem like it. Okay, we need 2 more clues. Blue's Clues, we got something right here. Cardboard irrelevant. It's not irrelevant if it was his house, dude. Sports car is a clue. Okay, the sports car stops in the middle of the intersection. All right, cool. That's kind of weird. Are the cars the clues? Engine smoke from ruptured radiator. Nothing there. That's the trunk. Hey, they got a Tennessee plate on it. Look at that. All right, we have 1 more clue. We got to figure out here. By the way, if you're wondering, it is Nashville Fire Department. That's cool. So we are actually in Nashville, Tennessee is where we're supposed to be. A pamphlet is a clue. Are you kidding me? Freddie Weaver participates in only... Okay, this one was kind of dumb. Kind of dumb and kind of simplistic. Okay, so participates in an illegal street race. Okay, obviously. And then Hampton's car smashes into sports car, or he stops in the middle of the intersection after hitting this dude. Is hit by his car. He comes to a stop and they hit him. Like, are you kidding me? That's it? Oh, that was a dumb one. Maddox is dead. In addition to several injuries, the crash broke William's left leg. As a result of his poor overall health, William immediately slipped into a coma. His health was so poor that he never recovered from it and died in the hospital 4 months later. Well, that's great. Freddie Weaver, your immediate assistance saved his life. Not that, his life was better than anybody else because he killed the dude. The paramedics were able to revive him on the way to hospital. His charge was causing serious injury by driving recklessly. Golly. Which eventually resulted in 10-year sentence. Jason didn't suffer any serious injuries from the accident, was quickly released. He soon became interested in Freddie Weaver's case, and some believe his testimony was the main reason for his unusually high sentence, although no one was able to find any solid evidence. Okay, what about his girl? The other Hampton. Let's hear her. Bethany. Just like her husband, the accident didn't cause her any major injuries. Just 2 weeks later, she was able to return to work as the mayor's assistant. Okay. This one... I love this one. It says, don't be too quick in assuming someone is dead. Only a doctor can do that. Yeah, I would say so. Well, we completed all of them except for the one that we did in the demo. That seems to be it for now, folks. So that's going to end this video of accidents. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. Really underwhelming, that street race one. Very underwhelming. The first one was cool. The cliff one was actually really neat. But street race, meh, not so much. Anywho, I'll see you next time. Take care. Hey guys, Jeff here. Just to let you know real fast that the merch is still available. You can check out the links below to go check it out. We have new Halloweens coming down the line. Thank you guys so much for the support. I really do appreciate it.